in many African countries. Mayaki said it was a contradiction that nutrition insecurity is still a major challenge in Africa, which is further complicated by high youth unemployment, yet the youth can find employment opportunities in the sector, making it a key employer in rural areas.
Second issue, the strategic thinking about agriculture goes beyond methods and processes, as I just said. And it has to pick up key issues which are related to market, to trade, to prices, to distribution of added value, to access to credit, to land. And by refocusing, it will make sense to all the stakeholders who think that sometimes carrot doesn't speak to their problems. And as a matter of fact, it also helps carrot speak to their problems through that debate.
Mayaki said rapid urbanization should be a major incentive to growth of the agriculture sector, since it provides a ready market for agricultural commodities and marketed food. President Uhuru Kenyatta, in an effort to stem the yawning gap in agricultural productivity, set in motion a strategy that will see high productivity in the sector. The president early in the year launched the Galana Irrigation Project that is expected to raise food production. The president, too, initiated the subsidized fertilizer program that is aimed at reducing the cost of agricultural production. The African Union Heads of State and Government meeting in Maputo in 2003 tasked member states to ensure that they increase funding to the agriculture sector to 10% of budgetary allocation and ensure a 6% growth in the sector. Judith Akolo, Business Defined.